devil up to make you think that God ain't studying about you. Yeah. But you, I stop by to tell you, you're going to make it through the storm. How many know there are storms in our lives? How many know every test, every trial, every temptation, every struggle is a storm? Yeah. But how many know the storm is designed to bless you, to give you patience, to hold on that God is going to see you through? How many know if you can believe God this afternoon, God will see you through the storm. As I begin to look at it, a great wind storm arises in the nighttime. How many realize that stuff come out at night?
Oh yeah.
Hey, got no help in here. How many know a couple get worse at midnight? Woo, my God. How many realize that, you know, you get disturbing news on the weekend when you can't do nothing about it? Right. How many know you can't get no answer, then the devil worry you all week long, weekend long about, I got to handle this situation on Monday. But I stop by to tell you, don't worry about what the devil is doing.
All right.
God said, we're going to make it to the other side.
Yeah.
I'm talking in here. How many realize the panic cries of the disciples echoes the urgent, oh my God, please, of the summons that the summons wrote. Then they cried unto the Lord in their trouble. Anybody ever cried in trouble?
All right.
And he brings them out of their distress.
Yeah.
Oh my God, here. He maketh the storm a calm.
Yeah.
So that the waves there are still.
Yeah.
Have there anybody ever been in a storm? They call on God.
Oh, yeah.
And when you called on God, then he make a way from you.
Yeah.
And how many know if he made a way that time, he'll make a way again.
Yeah.
But as I begin to look at the devil, he is no good.
Uh-huh.
Woo. And how many know the disciples, Jesus told them to get in the boat.
Uh-huh.
And they were so worried about the water filling the boat up, they forgot about the command of Jesus.
Uh-huh.
See, the devil know he couldn't do nothing with the words of Jesus.
Uh-huh.
So he had to get to the disciples so he could have to terrify them. See, the devil might not be able to get to you, but he'll get to the closest thing to you. And until they'll get to you. If he can't get in your husband, he'll get in your children. If he can't get in the children, he'll get in the grandchildren. If he can't get in the grandchildren, he start making your money funny.
All right. Yeah.
And then he got you all worried. I tell you that you can't serve God worthy. My God, you got to know that God is going to make a way out of nowhere. And how many realize that Jesus taking a power nap, sleeping on a pillar in the higher part of the sea. And how many know the water is filling up? Yeah, God, the wind is blowing, the breakers are dashing, and the storm is raging. But understand what Satan did. Satan knew it was over 6,000 of them in the tomb dweller. And he knew, he seen Jesus coming because he is the prince of the air. And so what he did, he spoke to the water. And he caused a storm to come up out of the water to try to drown Jesus on the boat before he can get there. How you know you can't fail with Jesus on board? Ain't got no help in here now. God, dare somebody say, I can't fail with Jesus on board. But how many realize the natural man is unable to see anything, not nature of glory of the kingdom of heaven? Unless the Lord is pleased to awaken him from darkness in which he dwells by the nature, giving him eyes to see and ears to hear. This sight of hearing are evidence of the new birth and subsequent gift of faith. How many realize that you can see stuff in faith that nobody else can see?
Right.
You can see yourself delivered even though you're still bound.
Yeah.
You can see yourself healed even though when you're still sick. But I got news for you. This season shall pass.
Yeah.
And God said we got to cross over to the other side.
Yes.
I'm almost there. How many know that Jesus had one purpose for coming to the earth? Actually, two purposes. One was to redeem us back in right relationship with God. The second purpose was to bind Satan. Ooh, how many know it's time for us to go back binding him? How many know we got too much texting and too much emailing the devil? Good God Almighty, it's too much gossiping talking to the devil all day long. How many know none of us is that deep and no smart that we can talk to the devil all day? Because you tell me you've been talking to the devil all day long. He'd already got you. He is a silver-tongued devil, and we're no match of ourselves or the devil. But how many know it's time to bind it? How many know you can't bind being half saved? You can't bind him without the Holy Ghost. How many know we got too many people joining our churches that ain't never been blood washed? And we're so excited by having them, we start elevating them. We put them in position before they get the fullness of God. And you wonder why you got all my children and one life to live going on. Because you got unbloodwashed people in your church. But I stop by to tell somebody in here, I don't care what. if Lord blessed me to see Sunday. My dad had been dead for 2 years, but the Lord gave me this. Said, no matter what happens, no matter what the storm is, no matter what the trouble is, no matter what I got to go through, the Lord, and I got Jesus, and I'm going to make it. Come on and high five your neighbors and neighbors. Let's go to the other side. Jesus got something in store for us. I'm almost out of here now. And I see the disciples, the boat is filling up with water. And how many know they're worried? I'm worried now. This last trial almost took me out of here. Do I got a witness in here? This last test, I flunked many times. But the day